Hey guys, Anthony, 4x4 diesel. Just a quick video, just showing you on the 150, we've got the scan gauge set up now, right? And I just want to show you how bad the software in these transmissions is firsthand, right? Now, there's a couple of statistics here all you need to look at. Looking on the screen here, you can see the outside air temperature is 9 degrees, right? So you know how cold it is. It's nearly 5 o'clock in the afternoon. It's not sunny, it's not hot. It's 9 degrees. We're in a GX Prado with no weight in it whatsoever, no camping gear, no towing, not even a tow bar, not even a bull bar. It's so nice and light. Stock standard cooling system, if you like. It hasn't been messed with. And look at that ATF, 103. I saw 107. Driving along, 100, 110 k's an hour-ish sorts of speeds, whether you use the cruise control or not. Almost impossible to have any sort of converter lock. Okay, you can get converter lock around 70, 80, 90 if it's fairly flat, because you've got less wind resistance, right? As you pick up speed, you're pushing into the wind more. Remember, the vehicle's a brick, right? These 150 Prados are pretty big. They're flat on the front. The windscreen's fairly upright. It's best described as a brick. It ain't no sports car. And we've just been sitting here idling with it in park. And even, I've got to tell you, the 120, the hottest I ever seen, the 120, and it's got a tow bar and it's done towing, and it never goes over 100 even towing. It'll be like 90, 95 maybe, this sort of thing, but usually lower than that. In the hottest temperatures, playing on sand dunes, the hottest I ever saw was about, normally I give it away when it hits 100, and that's a lot of mucking around in sand. So I've never seen anything like this, driving it right, as I say, and that's in hot temperatures. This is 9 degrees. Normally in the 120, it will drop down a lot quicker too. If you're sitting here idling in park, within 5 minutes it'll be back to coolant temperature. You can see coolant temp there, 85 degrees, okay. Coolant temp, 85. The coolant's running through the radiator, so it'll eventually come down, but for whatever reason, this one's happening very slowly compared to what the 120 does. There's not gonna be a video for a long time showing you this on the 120, simply because it never gets this hot, you know? I shouldn't say never, because, you know, maybe once a year or something, you know. If we're out in the high country and we're going up these consistent, massive, steep hills on a 35 degree day in the hot sun in the middle of the afternoon, it'll absolutely peak at about 100. Maybe 102, 103, that's what I've seen. As I said, this one's dropping slowly. At those times where I've seen it get up that hot, so it's mainly if we've got a really big sand dune. There's a few sand dunes around, but there's one in Tassie we normally have a play on, and if it's a hot day, you know, mid-20s in Tassie's a hot day, but anyway, we're having a crack playing on the sand, you're working the engine and the transmission really hard, so of course it's going to get hot. And normally when I see that figure right there, 100, that's where I just back it off, give it a rest. I'll get out, take some photos, make a video, and I'll leave the car. I always leave the car running. It'll be idling in park, and I'll come back to it a few minutes later, and it'll be down to 85. So this is taking a lot longer to cool down, and I noticed, even once I came off the 100, 110 zone, driving around in the 80 and 60 zone, it stayed up on 105, this ATF, the automatic transmission fluid temp, right? It stayed up on about 105. Even though I was driving very lightly and slowly, so hasn't really got a really good cooling effect. So it's the reason I'm making this video is someone asked me again this morning, so how do you like the new Prado, Ant? And I said, same as I said in the other 10 videos, and the same as I said to everybody else, it's a brand new Toyota, so of course we love the car. It's awesome, smooth, new quality, that's great. But the engine feels gutless compared to the 1KD. Now that's probably a bit of an over, you know, I'm just being exaggerating a little bit. It's kind of smoother and quieter because it's new, but when you squeeze it, you don't get the power or the torque, the seat of the pants feeling, and it wants to change gears, unlock and rev too much. So that's my feeling with it. I don't like the engine for that reason. It hasn't got the go. The vehicle's underpowered. I've mentioned this in other videos. It's underpowered. It's like a Subaru. I'll use that example because the Subarus seem to be always underpowered. Do you know what I mean? You know, your Subaru Outback, awesome vehicle, but with that 2.5 litre flat four-cylinder petrol engine, it just didn't have anything to get it going. But it did the job. It was okay. Don't get me wrong. Great cars. As this is, my biggest issue with this is the transmission, the six-speed, the software. I've mentioned in other videos. I'm not going to go on about it too much. I mainly wanted to demonstrate. So this is going to be a short one, guys. Look at that. 5 minutes. I'm just about done. I just wanted to demonstrate how hot the transmission can get. And guess what? They can get a lot hotter than that. But we're in 9 degrees. 9 degrees. It didn't do hard driving. Do you know what I mean? We're just driving along. Let me look outside. Put the window down. Is it windy today? Let's have a look. Let's get a bit of environment. Just so you got a picture, see? Yeah, the sun's going down, it's down over there behind the clouds. That's a nice view, isn't it? Look at those trees. They're not moving, so it's not windy. We didn't have a headwind or anything like that. Right? Look, it's just crazy. It's just always slipping. So you get, in these six-speed autos, you get converter lock-in 4th, 5th and 6th, okay? Now, if I was to drop it back to 4th at 110, it'll get converter lock. It'll hold lock really well. But you're revving it a lot. It's revving over 3 grand. You shouldn't have to do that. You should at least be able to get converter lock in 5th because the revs are up over 2,000, sort of between 2 and 2.5, depending what speed. You should be able to get converter lock at those speeds under light acceleration. But you can't, unfortunately, right? Not a bad view, eh? That sky there. Anyway, I'm going to get out and check that out. That's what I'm here for. Anyway, guys, I just wanted to show you. Beware. This one will be called Beware of the Hot 6-Speed Transmission, whatever it is, in the 1GD FTV Prados. They're getting hot. They're cooking. Beware. Guys, if you found that helpful, give us a thumbs up. If you haven't already, I've earned your subscription. Please subscribe, turn the bell on so you don't miss the next bit of information, and I'll be looking at the comments. Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for your support. See ya.